Hello, everyone. How are you doing? How are you feeling? It has been a while since I popped on and given an energy update, and I really felt called to start these up again. So I'm just set up in my room right now. So it's not the best setup in terms of space, but I just felt really called to bring forth some of the messages that I'm receiving. If you are new to what I do, my name is Jennifer Glendenning, and I am an intuitive. I'm able to see images, hear, feel. I work with my guides to bring through the latest energy updates or anything that I feel has really made a shift in energy impact within me. I'm able to kind of feel it before it really takes stage. So enough said, let me just start. I feel that this energy is a deep transformational energy. And you've probably heard that many, many, many times. But I'm seeing a snake, and the snake of transmutation, transcendence, transformation. So my guides also bring through, again, images and symbols. And the snake is one of the symbols that is coming through. And there are a couple of messages within this. So yes, one of deep transformation, transmutation, transcendence, but they're also showing the shedding of skin, the shedding of layer. You know, we are entering a new way of living and being. And a lot of that is really uncertain right now because we're co-creating it. And so one of the reasons that I am being guided to bring forth this is that we are being asked to recognize within ourselves the patterns, the stories that we have created and co-created within our reality. And so when we look back, this energy, there's a lot of going back over and slowing down. It's almost like we're moving forward, but pulling back the reins to say, okay, in these situations, in different circumstances, let's pick a relationship. How did I act and react in that relationship? And how much have I grown since that time? So years past, how much have I grown? If I look back, I can say to myself, wow, I might have reacted then, but I'm not now. And because many of you are moving into a deeper state of awareness, a deeper state of knowing, a deeper state of understanding how energy works, you are able to cut that tie and free yourself, creating this lightness and this expansiveness. So this is one of the things that's happening, is we are pulling back so that we can look deep within, to peel back, to shed, to release parts of ourselves, right? That identity, false identity, that egoic ideas and concepts that have been pushed upon us, brainwashed within us, to say, hey, wait a second here, you know, what is it that I want? How do I want to live? And then with that, saying, how do I start that? How do I create that? what steps do I need to take? You know, and that's when the ego can come in and say, can you really do that? Well, I don't know. Can you? And this is like allowing yourself to move through this. And this is this energy, this ebb and flow energy. And when I say transmuting the energy, it's like we know that if we don't clear it, understand it, transmute it, it's only going to come back and look us right in the face again. So, you know, this is something that's really important for us to, as a society, to really look at and within us. Now, there was another, it actually came up in a meeting, and I also received songs. And one of the songs that came up is, watch yourself, show me what you're working with. And I thought, I've heard that song before. It was a long time ago, but I Googled it and I thought, I am definitely not putting this song out. Hold on, I'm gonna go get my card. But when I looked deeper into that, it was, it is all about shaking it off, parts of the lower chakras, your solar plex, your I am center. What have you been holding on to, that identity of who you are and how you should show up in the world? So really shaking off and shedding, releasing the energy that we have been holding in the lower chakras. Okay, so this is like home, our home where we live, our finances, money, right? Our views on money. This also has to do with our creative process, and you know, what we are creating and what we're not creating. This also has to deal with healing the divine feminine, the divine masculine, the sexual energies, healing tons of, you know, healing the womb space. So there's lots coming up with that. I just wanted to get these parts. Now, I, again, don't really use cards. You can see that there's a whole bunch of different cards that I just put in, but I am going to pull these. I feel like there's three coming out right now. So as we move into these February energies, I feel like this is a really good time. I'm hearing like this incubation time, and okay, I'll be back on in a bit. I feel like this is this time that we are being supported to really go over what it is that we are ready to create. And once March comes, I really feel like there's going to be that momentum. Right now, it's this yin and yang energy of, let's create, but what do I want? You know, just this balance, the word balance comes up. How can you create that within you? So it's interesting. The card that I pulled in this deck, I have no idea what this deck is. Like I said, I just had some loose cards. This is an air. So I would say with this is that mental turbulence. This is about creating that equilibrium within the left and the right side of the brain, really coming into a sense of knowing what it is that you want, quieting the mind, bringing yourself into center, bringing yourself into balance. It says plans for revision. And this is exactly what I'm hearing and seeing is, what do you need to go back over? What do you need to revise? Maybe what you thought you wanted 6 months ago or a year ago, maybe you don't want that anymore. Or maybe, you know, you want it, but there's some things you need to revise to get it going again. And you know what I mean, procrastinators out there. And hey, listen, That is myself as well. So more going on than meets the eye. Yes, there's a lot of energy moving. There's a lot of things going. And this is not the time to let's get going. This is the time to really move in and feel and see what it is that the inner workings I'm hearing, so that you are able to lay it out almost like a blueprint and then get it going. You know, it's almost like they're showing this revisions of let's say, you know, your home. This is just an analogy. And you're like, okay, I want to move this washroom over here. I want this larger. I want this. So this is about you going over these revisions and really asking yourself what it is that you want. Whoa, we got a card that flew right out of the deck. Sorry, it bounced here. Probably going to look back at this and go, oh, this video. Okay. This is a time for celebrating. And I feel like the reason why this came forth, it's, you know, celebrate the work that you have done. Celebrate your accomplishments. You know, this is about that message that came through, looking back and saying and understanding, look how far you've come. Look how far you've grown. Look at who you are right now through spiritual development, through deeper awareness. This is time to celebrate. Again, I'm hearing and feeling shaking off the old. Okay. You are being supported here. There's a lot of supportive energies. And I'm also hearing and feeling with this joy, you know, joy, that higher expression of who you are. Don't take things too seriously, you know, allow yourself to laugh, because some of you watching may take things so seriously. We got another card out of the deck. This is amazing. This light. I posted on my Instagram, this little melody, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, this little light of mine. And it's about allowing yourself to shine bright. Where have you in the past dimmed your light or stepped back? So, you know, perhaps you could let somebody else be that. This is all about you really allowing yourself to blossom, to express, to be all that you can be. I mean, you have been reincarnated here for a reason, right? And it's time to allow that to unfold. Be the light. Shine, and however that shows up for you. And honestly, when I'm really feeling this, I'm seeing through creativity, through expression, through joy, through playfulness. Oh my, look at what came out again. Balance. This is about bringing balance and equilibrium. This is about you being, I am centered, I am grounded in the full expression of who I am. And what is that? What brings that? What shines your light? Because let's just do one more. Wow, you've got the power. You have got the power. Use your abilities to resolve the situation. You can do it. Again, this is about you going in. This is about you going in, a little light language for you. This is about you going in and reassessing, re-advising. This is about you taking control of your life, taking ownership of your energy and what you need to do, what steps you need to do to get there. I also feel like, and I've talked about this on another platform too, I feel like there's going to be a lot of travel this year. I feel like there's going to be a lot of deeper curiosities when it comes to energies and connecting with the earth and the expressions of the energies within the David community, the crystal kingdoms, you know, just a lot of newfound energies within the lands. I'm really feeling that. And I'm really feeling like this energy is going to work with us in terms of expanding our throat chakra, this expression, how we express ourselves into the world, there's so much lightness. And I want to go back to this, you know, it's like a fairy. It's light. It's light. It's lighter. It's light. You know, this energy is so, that's moving in is so much lighter, and that we're able to free ourselves and move freely. I'm hearing, you know, if we choose heart chakra, yes, we are, our hearts are expanding. We are being supported in this, definitely supported in this. Power of intention. This is why these cards are just all over the place, because powerful messages. Again, this is about taking responsibility and accountability for our own energy and how we intentionally, consciously choose to move throughout our days, throughout our weeks, throughout our months. And also I'm hearing who we choose to intertwine that energy with. Okay. There's so much change about to happen. And if we go back to the snake, you know, this is also a divine feminine energy, okay? Allow that true expression of who you are. Let the divine feminine rise within you. Allow your creative juices to flow freely. And don't let that limit yourself. Right? Don't let your ego stop you from exploring and diving deeper into the unknown, the unknowns of what we are co-creating. So these are just some of the energies that are coming up in the first part of February. I do intend to hop back on in a couple of weeks. But I hope this resonated with you. You can also check me out on Instagram at jennifer.glendenning. And I am sending you so much love, so much light. If you would like a personal reading with me, you can visit my website. And I will I'll put the link below. If you have any questions or would like to join a meditation, also, you can contact me on my website or through here. Again, sending you so much love, and I will talk to you all soon. Bye for now.